quick hands when he's got stick handling skills like we just saw. And it's exactly what allowed him to put one on the board there, guys.
Dishes it to Prokop. Zone. From the right side and up the middle. Stopped by the goaltender. He got a little piece of that one. And he slides it quickly to Bouwmeester. Taken by Gunther. Carries the puck through the neutral zone. Makes a move in front. Tosses it on to Prokop. And now it's over to Eichel. And he loses possession of the puck after trying to make one too many moves.
Eichel's got the green light to try this move almost anywhere on the ice. The coaches have great faith in his ability, but he just can't complete it.
A chance on goal. And a great save.
How he does it, but there's another scoring chance.
Cutting to the front of the net.
Tuukka's fantastic at defending in one-on-one situations. His shutdown zone ability, guys, it allows him to stop the opponent from getting a good scoring chance when they're coming in against him.
Tuukka's got it now deep inside his own end. Slides the puck ahead to Doughty. Nylander's swooping in on the attack. Bergeron's got control of the puck in the corner. Across the point. Great reach with the poke check. Puts it into the back of the net for the goal!
Yeah, breaks this tie, James. You know when these teams get locked up tight, sometimes it stays that way a long time.
The Kraken have found themselves an all-critical goal here in this third period.
Still a lot of time left, though. They've had the possession chart in their favor, but you need more pucks, more forecheck, more work. Play the game down the other end of the ice.
And he sends it across to Kuznetsov. And he slides it quickly to Nylander. Here's a chance! There it is! They score! Johnny on the spot! He tucks in the rebound!
We got to see a solid assist on that play, and it comes back to his superstar ability. That's a great example of how he can set up his team for success.
Edmonton's won the draw in the neutral zone. Cuts to the front! Oh, and scores!
Through to the net. He picks up this rebound. Makes no mistake. Once the goalie leaves the puck in front of the net, the goalie's at your mercy, and he does not miss.
Edmonton's got control of it now from their own end. Moves around along the half wall. They fight for it along the boards. Oh, he'll feel that one. Takes it across the blue line. Here's a shot. Gets a glove on it to make the save.
This is the most fun time of a hockey game. When every play is so important, the game is tight, everything is on the line, and your decisions and execution is what's going to make the difference.
Let's get to a stage in the game where you think they're not going to be able to find the equalizer, but they stay at it, and they get it done.
That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
Edmonton's won the draw, and they take possession here in the open ice. On the attack along the boards. The Kraken have gained control of the puck along the wall. Looking dangerous as they move along the boards. Hangs onto the puck. Stopped by the goaltender. The Kraken have the puck against the boards. Oh, and it stays out with the toe save. Wrist one in front. And puts it anywhere but the way he wanted it to go. You'll need more than that to beat him. Was on top of that for the whistle.
Pretty quickly on top of it to kill the play.
A lot on the line here in this offensive zone faceoff. Dreisaitl's won the draw. And that shot dies in traffic. Broken up by Carlson. The Kraken have gained possession off the wall. Slides the puck over. Edmonton's ready to go on the attack. Moves it quickly over to Sider. Gains the zone through center. Quick pass to Brown. The Kraken have possession along the boards. And he regains control of the puck. Along the side, here they come through the neutral zone. Jabs the puck away. Edmonton's looking to break out of their own end. Moves it to Eichel. The Oilers have it against the wall. Under a minute to go here in regulation time. And that goes off a player in front. Now over to Carlson. The Oilers grab possession of the puck. Edmonton's got control of it. He scores! It's in! And that's three right!
I think he's the most surprised guy in the building. Look at the way he reacted when that puck went into the net. Outstanding effort.
He's been so good tonight because of his zone ability, and there's another example of him using it to produce, guys.
Snatches the puck with the two centermen locked up. Went for the dirty dangle, and it goes sideways. They need a goal. Scores into the empty net.
Well, he shouldn't miss that. I mean, there's nobody standing there. Put it in the cage, man.
No pressure, right?
Edmonton's added to their lead with the empty netter, and Ray, that's pretty much all she wrote, I would say.
Well, you grind away to get the lead through this much of the game, and they pull the goalie, they're going to pressure you. You put it away with an easy one into the empty net.
They've got to find a way to get some offense here, and they've got the extra attacker route with the goaltender at the bench. Long reach breaks up the momentum. A chance to end it, and it goes wide. Quick feed to Crosby. And now he tries to get it across to Connor. Unloads a shot! Gets a piece of it with the glove! And that'll close the book on this one as the final horn sounds.
They went for the tie by getting the goaltender out of there, and as a result, they end up giving up the empty netter. So while the final score is 2, it was really a close game.
Yeah, that's the one thing. When you look at the initial score, it'll look like a dominant victory, but this one wasn't decided until very late here.
The ice is ready. The teams are ready. Officials set to drop the puck. Here we go. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro set to bring you all this hockey ultimate team matchup. And there's the puck drop. Enough talk. It's time to find out what this is all about. And he makes the easy save.
Good technique as the puck is over to the corner, out of the way.
From the right side, they gain the zone. Oh, scores!
And when I was playing at home, I loved if we could get on the board first. It really makes you feel like you can throw four or five into the net.
Team Switzerland's execution on the offensive end pays off quickly, Ray.
Didn't take them long, did it? They're attacking quickly. They capitalize on an opportunity, and now they can play the game from in front.
Jostles the puck loose. Scrum along the boards. Slides into line A. Moves the puck into the attacking area. And that one flies over the net. And he easily stops that one. That's a slash on that play. The referee's all over it. And let's see what the definitive call is on the ice.
Well, this isn't going to help the comeback, but you can get right back at it. But the penalty killers have to do their job first.
Team Switzerland's man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
First chance of the night for the power play. The guys are pretty excited to get out there and see if they can get on the board.
Kane's got the puck along the wing. The Oilers looking against the half wall. Team Switzerland's got the puck along the boards. Takes it to the front. And they score! And we've...
Welcome back, everybody. Alongside Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. It's the Hockey Ultimate Team Showdown here this evening, and the puck is set to drop.
Oh, I've been waiting for this all day, and we are now officially underway.
Tries to make a move and can't hang on to the puck.
Kane's hands make him always a danger around the offensive zone, but he can't pull this one off.
Scores! Oh, what a finish on his part!
Great hands, and you know that the player is confident when they can pull this move off in so tight. What a great play! And he finishes it by beating the goaltender.
He stick handles so well, guys, and that goal is how he can create something out of nothing. It's his puck on a string zone ability, and he finished off that sequence, making it look so easy.
Made the stop on that play.
I love watching him do this. It's like he's got the puck on a string. He just dangles around defenseman, draws him in, goes around him, gets a chance on net. This time, though, the goalie beats him.
And that's a great read to force the turnover. Couldn't complete the pass. Stamkos works the puck in his own zone. Here he is with the backhander. That opportunity is rejected. Wrist shot from the slot. They score! It's in! He gets a hold of his own rebound.
Once this puck bounces off the goaltender the first time, the shooter's the next guy in position. The D can't turn quick enough, and he puts it away into the net.
Faceoff here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway.
Man, did he steamroll over top of him there, Seaball.
Look out, that was a freight train on that one. Team Switzerland's on the attack. Poked away in the defensive end. Picked up along the wall by McKinnon. Edmonton's got the puck in the defensive end. And now it's grabbed by Brown. Goes right to the crease. Oh, and that stays out with the toe save.
Yeah, he got out tight to him, James. There's nowhere for that puck to go.
We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. Edmonton's really controlled the pace of play these last few minutes, leading by two. Slides the puck across to Kyrou. Taken by McDavid.
Team Switzerland's got it along the wall. Big stop by the goaltender right in front. Big stop by the keeper. Tries to get the puck to Hyman. Edmonton's playing it from the side. Chance in front. Scores! Leon Draisaitl.
Guys, we know he's a powerful player, and we saw it with his big rig superstar ability there. He shielded the puck with his body as he drove it to the net, and it was the perfect play as he scores a beauty of a goal.
Here's a short pass to Nylander. From the left side into the middle of the neutral zone. Oh, look at this chance! Here's a shot! Turned aside with a glove! There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Teams are ready to go, and we're about moments away from puck drop. Carter's won it off the faceoff. And the intensity's starting to ramp up here after that hit. Here's a shot! Big-time saving goal as he gets all of it with the stick. Edmonton's playing it through center. Grabbed along the boards by Eichel. Puck scooped up by Goudreau. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Nylander. Look at the Savardian spinorama. Puck moved over to Puljujarvi. Tried to get 2Q with it and loses possession.
Whoops, probably not the right time to try that. A little bit too fancy. Maybe a simpler play would have done.
The old double dip makes this a fantastic night for you. You know it's your night. You're feeling it. And now he's got two.
Guys, we all know he's good at stick handling, and that was a great example of it. That puck on a string zone ability buys him some space and allows him to get one on the board. You just love to see it.
Pad save. He's on it tonight. Line A's carrying it ahead. Snaps it onto the net. He scores!
On the night for him. They've really been effective forechecking, a couple of breaks, and now he's got two.
A quick flick of the wrist, and that snapshot beats the goaltender. He's in the low slot. He doesn't have much time to think about it.
Here in the late goings of the period, the Oilers have really extended this lead. It's looking like a squash now. Brown's got it against the boards. Here's a chance with the stop. We'll get a face-off after the puck stays covered up. Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. Edmonton's got it in the offensive zone. And that's denied by Anderson. There's another stop. And that's knocked away by Carlson. Team Switzerland's regained possession of the puck. Moves it quickly over to Carlson. Gains the zone from the right. Edmonton's gained possession along the boards. Here we go. It's a 2-on-1. And he makes the save. Stops him again.
Doesn't lose his focus as he makes a couple of quick ones in a row.
Quick pass to McDavid. Team Switzerland's got it across the line. The Oilers will play it through the neutral zone. Let's the wrister fly. Stop that one. There's the horn, ending the first period. Both teams will have a chance to regroup. You do you, and we'll be back with period number two in a moment. Both teams back on the ice after the first intermission. Ray Ferraro, James Cebulski, ready to bring you the call for period number two. Period number two underway here. Has been an absolute mismatch through the first 20 minutes. One period already in the books. Ray, how have you seen this thing?
Edmonton's game plan has been executed almost to perfection. They've had the puck the whole time, and they have a pretty comfortable lead.
Across the line. Oh, makes the save. That was a rocket. Lots of time left in this period. Edmonton's got a 5-0 lead. That's right, 5-0 is where we sit. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Nice poke check. Angles it over to Puljujarvi. Long lead pass into the neutral zone. Edmonton's got the puck. Through the open ice, they're picking up steam. Rister turns it aside with the glove.
Great tracking. He finds the puck. He gets the glove up, makes the save on a dangerous chance.
Both teams readying here for the faceoff. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Moves it to Kyrou. That pass doesn't go. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. Pushes it across to McDavid. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck now. Team Switzerland's got control of the puck. Edmonton's got possession here in the offensive zone. Can't connect on the pass. And now it's grabbed by Kyrou. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. Stopped by the goaltender. Oh, they do it again!
Great stop by the goaltender again. Back-to-back saves.
Oh, and it's another save on the play.
Watts had a really easy night here, James. I don't know how it could be much easier than this.
Lugs the puck into the offensive zone corner. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. Icing is the call. We'll get a face-off at the other end. Still lots of time left in the period. Edmonton's put on a smothering offensive performance. They lead it 5-0. The Oilers take possession off the faceoff.
They'll be back on their heels. They lose the draw.
Trying to shake the defender. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Fantastic goal! Team Switzerland's got one here in the second. They need many more to follow, though.
Yeah, but they've got to start somewhere, I guess. Something positive, something to build on, but it's been a pretty rotten game for them so far.
From the neutral zone now. Team Switzerland's got the puck in their own end. The Oilers gain control of it. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. Scores! And right back the answer!
You have to be able to respond to moments that happen that aren't very favorable to you. They give up a goal, and they go get it right back.
The Oilers continue to pour it on here in the back half of this second period, Ray.
All they want to do is get this to the intermission in the shape they're in. They're very comfortable now.
From the left side, takes it at center. Rocked on the play. Oh, and that's got the crowd buzzing after that stop.
Really good positioning as he makes the stop from in tight.
And that somehow stayed out of the net. Anderson's going to hang on to that one for a whistle.
Quickly on top of that, James. He needed a cover there.
Some last-second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. Team Switzerland's won the faceoff deep in their own end. Kane stick-handling in his own zone. Takes it to the net! Fantastic save!
Aggressive stop out on top of the crease to make the save on a dangerous chance.
Rips it on net! Denies him on the slapper! And as he opts to freeze the puck, we get a whistle.
Starting to look like a little bit of a fire drill in the zone, so this is a good play.
Stamkos has it in their own end. Takes the feed. And now he moves it to Kane. Things starting to get a little physical out there. Edmonton's got the puck. Gains the zone from the right side. To his teammate. The score! My goodness, what a shot of the one-timer! Edmonton's widened the gap yet again tonight, Ray.
How far can you widen a gap? Because they keep adding on to it. It seems like shift by shift.
Beautiful read in the defensive end by Hyman.
The Oilers have been in the perfect position, it seems, all night. There's another intercepted pass.
Edmonton's got possession here in their own end.
He had to dig in there after the icing call. Players get tired, but you win the draw, you can get out of the zone.
Along the half wall with the puck. And he's able to handle that one. Goaltender hangs on for the whistle. Team Switzerland's won the draw. Getting a little physical out there, but still holds on to the puck. Over the line they come. Taken by Tarasenko. Answered the call on that play. Barzal's got it in the offensive zone. Sends a pass over. The Oilers gain control of the puck. Up along the wall on the right side and into the attacking area. And that's the hat trick! Listen to this place!
And here come the hats. I love this tradition, although I will tell you, they collect the hats up. They used to give them to us, and you're like, what am I going to do? I'm not wearing somebody else's hat.
Edmonton's been pounding them all over the ice tonight. Ray, what's been your assessment?
Physically, skating, skill, they've been the better team in any category you want.
And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. That's not going to fool him. And there's the horn bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. Here we go. Third period set to get underway. Simply too much to not enough at this point. Ray, with two periods in the books, what are your thoughts on the game to this point?
Edmonton's focus now is just lock down this game. Comfortable lead. They've been terrific through 40 minutes. Don't give it away now.
Milch is going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around as the shift gets long. This helps.
Officials getting ready to drop the puck. Puck possession so key in today's game. Nice start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone. And the puck stopper jumps on top of it to get a stoppage in play. Team Switzerland's got it in the defensive zone. Milch is going to hang on to the puck for a whistle. Team Switzerland's got a hold of the puck. Edmonton's got it now. Team Switzerland's got the puck along the wall. Quick feed to Russell. Here's a shot! Takes that one right in the logo! And there's the whistle, giving him a chance to exhale! The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here. Moves it quickly over to Kane. Edmonton's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Taken along the wall by Brown. Into the corner of the attacking area. Stick save, and I think that went off the shaft of his stick there. I can dig it. And it's in the back of the net here for him. Wait a second, They're calling this off.
Yeah, they're gonna take a look at this for sure, but the call on the ice now is no goal.
No change in the score as that... was waved off and we are ready to drop the puck again. Team Switzerland's won the draw. The Oilers gain possession. Moves the puck behind the net. Team Switzerland's got control of it now from their own end.